can turn the world on with a smile. You can take a nothing day and suddenly make it all seem worthwhile. What a secret, and you should know it. Each glance and every little movement you show it.
Love is all around.
No need to fake it.
You can never tell.
Why don't you take it? You're gonna make it after all.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Jodie Emery Show. Today is Thursday, October 13th. I've just got a few things to share with you this week. I got a photo of Mark in his graduation cap and gown for getting his GED down in prison. It says on the back, "Dearest Miss, I quite like this photo. With my voracious consumption of books, magazines, and the New York Times, I feel quite educated. Your boo." So he's like excited. I have his tassel and everything. And as you've seen in previous shows, I've shown you his diploma and the graduation booklet, and he did get top marks in the prison, and he's in the top 1% of the state of Mississippi for getting his grade 12. So there he is, graduating so many years after high school. Mark has the petition on the White House website, and in my recent shows I've mentioned that. It's past the threshold that we needed to get a response from the White House, but we're still encouraging people to go and sign it, and we're getting media coverage of it too. So CKNW Radio talked to me about it the other day, and CTV News, and they're all very interested in Mark having this petition to get pardoned being presented to the U.S. president, so that's pretty cool. One of the news stories that showed up was in The Province, and they've been very good to us with coverage. John Ferry wrote an article about this new vaccine that's supposed to stop people from feeling the effects of alcohol or drugs or anything that's not good for them, and he asked me for my thoughts on it. So my Facebook page has this linked, and you can read the full article, but it does mention that Mark's petition to be pardoned is past the threshold and that we will get a response. And I'm always so happy to see pictures with our Cannabis Canada flag, because it's the flag I feel the most allegiance to, really, and it's great to see it in the paper. So Mark's petition is one of only a number of them. Not too many have gotten past the threshold needed for a response, but the number one petition is to legalize marijuana similar to alcohol. And we had our friend and supporter Tommy Chong stop by Cannabis Culture just the other day to do a video promoting the petition and asking people to help get involved in ending prohibition. And you can see that here on the Pot TV Network channel on YouTube, and we'll post a link to it on cannabisculture.com as well, and as always on all our Facebook accounts too. So make sure you subscribe to the channel you're watching now, Pot TV Network, and see all the other things that we have to share. But it was great to have Tommy come by. He even got to talk to Mark on the phone and let him know that he's really proud of him playing music and everything. So that was great to have his support. As always, he's been very good to us. The petition is still going on. We still have a few days left until the 30-day limit on the 23rd. So be sure to sign it if you haven't already. The link is at cannabisculture.com and at freemark.ca. And of course, at freemark.ca, we have Mark's mailing address. So if you want to give him an early Christmas present, maybe subscribe him to a magazine that you think he might be interested in. He's already got quite a few, and if you read his blogs, you'll see which ones he's been reading. But he appreciates letters a lot, especially from people who are active and taking part in ending prohibition, no matter where they live. He got some great postcards from someone in Iceland, even, who's been in touch with him. So Mark has supporters all over the world because he's worked so hard to help people everywhere on this earth, and it's great to have their support in return. And we hope that if you know somebody who's struggling, going through imprisonment or being arrested, with Obama and Harper both cracking down on cannabis, we're sure to see a lot more people suffering under these drug laws, which continue to get worse even though it should get better. So please be sure to help those you know who are suffering in whatever way from this insane drug war, this insane war on cannabis, and be sure to be strong together, because as things get tough, and they certainly seem to be going that way, we'll have to rely on each other to get through the hard times. In Vancouver this weekend, I'll give a shout out to the Occupy Vancouver movement, which is starting their occupation at the Art Gallery downtown here on this weekend. I'll be gone to visit MARC in Mississippi, so I won't be able to attend, but certainly our message of freedom from oppressive government is something that we're all on the same page. So I support Vancouver and every other city. There's over 200 cities around the world taking part in this Occupy movement to show the government and the corporations that have really cheated the people that we know what's going on and it's not fair and things need to change. So whatever way you choose to enforce that message, be sure to keep standing tall and spreading those good words, because we need to speak truth to power if we want to get anything done. And it's better to try and change things and fail than to not try at all. So let's give it our best. Be sure to tune in to POT TV. We have live shows happening every week. On Monday, it's McMahon with the Opus show, or Opus Mic, I believe it is. And we've got Greg Williams on Wednesdays with From Under the Influence with Marijuana Man. And on Fridays, of course, is Cannabis Culture News Live with our editor, Jeremiah, who's here in the office now. And be sure to tune in then for all the great news about what's going on in the world of weed. And check out cannabisculture.com/store. We've got reduced prices on Volcano vaporizers and all sorts of other great things available, so be sure to check it out. We really appreciate your business and support, because we try as hard as we can to keep the message getting out there, not only in Vancouver, but in our country and all around the world. It's one message of freedom, and we're glad to have everyone on our side. So thank you, as always, for your support and tuning in. Take care, everybody, and free Mark Emery.